Well, the newly formed ABS-CBN Philharmonic Orchestra, a professional orchestra in Manila under the baton of music director Gerard Salonga, has been getting rave reviews from music critics for their enthusiastic interpretations of great symphonic works.
Well, this month, the ABS-CBN Philharmonic Orchestra teams up with renowned classical pianist Cecile Licad for a truly unique musical treat. Here's a sample.
On the morning stage today is ABS-CBN Philharmonic Orchestra music director and conductor Gerard Salonga and his extremely talented team of musicians. Well done, guys.
I know.
All right. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk music, really.
All right.
Yeah.
Great.
Go ahead,
Jin.
The last time that I saw Maestro, it was right before a different concert.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Of course, this is the third team up that you'll have with Cecile Licad, which I think everyone is really kind of looking forward to.
Yes.
Tell us about this. The pianist's pianist.
Yes, actually, it's not just the title of a show. It's a moniker given to her by the New Yorker magazine.
Mm-hmm.
When you say that someone is a pianist's pianist, then that's a pretty high compliment
right.
to any musician.
Okay.
And we're pretty excited to have her here. Mm-hmm. We've had her in the past. She's played with the ABS-CBN Philharmonic before, and we're just really psyched about it, and we really hope people will come and see it.
This is good stuff. What's it like working with such a talented group of people? I mean, we said that you guys, you know, are fairly newly formed in terms of orchestras. What's it like working with a group of talented people like this?
It's very hard.
Mm-hmm.
It's just because the expectations are high on both ends. Mm-hmm. I expect a lot from them, and they expect a lot from me.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to be on my toes all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good. It's uh-huh. good. It's uh-huh. it's difficult, but it's good.
Right.
But what's nice, because you guys have been getting such great feedback or mm-hmm. such great reviews, is that little by little, I think classical music is making a broader presence.
Yes.
We can say, I mean, even with the programs,
yes.
with of course the special concerts that you guys have, and the educational outreach programs also. Mm-hmm.
That's right. We have a bunch of educational concerts that we give to school children.
Mm-hmm.
But this is not just something that's up to us. You know, it's mm-hmm. it's up to the audience themselves to unshackle themselves and give it a try.
Right. Yeah. So how do you bring classical music to a much broader audience? I mean, it's interesting that you yourself are such a multi-disciplined musician in terms of composing, conducting, musical directing. You work with contemporary forms as well, the kitchen musical, big hits like that. But still, you manage to sort of spread yourself evenly over these different genres and different disciplines.
Well, it's all a matter of taking the boundaries away in people's mind. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Just like in my mind, there's no boundary.
Right.
The music is music, it's all good stuff. Mm-hmm. And slowly and but surely, we're teaching people that as well.
Well, I think you said it well when you said unshackled. There's really the impression sometimes that maybe classical music is, for me, maybe I won't be able to know any of the songs, but the reality is we've heard a lot of the sounds, the tunes,
yes,
the music before, just can't really correlate the song and the music to, you know, maybe so well or so so distinctively.
It might not be a case of familiarity either. Mm. When you see a beautiful painting for the first time, you get hit by it, just like if you hear a beautiful piece of music for the first time, you get hit by it. You just have to be willing to go and experience
it. Like, yeah, like you said, yeah, I mean, you have to go to the museum and take a look at this picture, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What are we in for in this third team up of you and Cecile?
Well, she's going to play a couple of real pianist stuff.
Okay.
Really strong pianist works.
Okay.
Franz Liszt Concerto number one. Mm-hmm. And Franz Liszt, Toten Tanz, it's a beautiful piece.
Wow.
And the orchestra is going to play some Beethoven and some Liszt as well. And
okay.
It's going to be just a great evening, and we're going to just really set up those pieces really beautifully for her.
Wow, that sounds like quite a list.
I know.
Yeah, no pun intended.
Okay. So it sounds like it's going to be super.
Yes, tell us about when and where.
June 29th at the Tanghalang Nicanor Abelardo, also known as, of course, more popularly, the CCP Main Theater. 8 p.m. And people can buy their tickets at Ticket World, 891-9999.
Good stuff.
Sounds good. What are some of the other things? I know we're seeing the details up on the screen. What are some of the other things that we can look forward to from ABS-CBN?
Oh, we have some really interesting concerts coming up. In August, we have a concert called The Best ng Pilipinos, which, as you can imagine, is a tribute to the greatness of Filipino talent.
And we certainly have.
We've got a lot of that.
A lot of that.
In September, we have a really great concert coming up. It's called Around the World with Disney.
Right.
Oh,
so we're teaming up
nice.
With Disney, and we're getting all the music from the Disney Concert Library in the States.
That's gonna be super.
And we're going to just wow everybody. It's going to be a great family concert for everybody.
Super. Lots to look forward to.
Yeah.
And well, first things first, don't miss this show.
Yes.
You know, the pianist is going to be, it's going to be really, really exciting stuff. But like you said, you know, you got to bring the music to the people, and the people have to be there to listen to it. There's probably no better opportunity than to ask you guys for another sample.
We're bringing
our pleasure.
It to
all
the
right,
people.
Maestro, please, the orchestra.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.